Okay, Casper, the gas prices. Everybody's talking about it. Everybody has an opinion about it. Every newspaper, I mean, the Spanish news, any news item in the world is talking about the high energy prices. You have five reasons why it is that high, the prices of gas are that high. And I want that you share those reasons with our viewers.
I will do, Martin.
Thank you. But first, obviously, what happened? And it was a pretty turbulent week, I think, for people that are investing. On Monday, we had a really big drop, and then we saw some recovery on Tuesday. So there's a lot of things that happened. If we look in Germany, the factory orders fell, and also the export went down for the first time in 15 months. So that was obviously a bit of a negative news item this morning, and that overshadowed the positive news from China. Chinese markets were closed for about a week due to holidays. They opened, people had a lot of, they wanted to buy stocks again, and they were very enthusiastic. But the German negative news overruled that slightly. We had TUI, the travel company, shares down 13%. We also mentioned it earlier this week that they're going to raise 1 billion capital basically to restructure and still pay off some trouble that they had from COVID. Their stocks went down 13%. Important, I think, for this afternoon, we're recording this around midday, that we're going to see what is going to happen with the American job reports. People are expecting 500,000 new jobs, and that's more than double than what was generated in September. It was 235,000 jobs. Daimler, positive week. They had an upgrade from UBS. And Evergrande, I think, I do want to mention it. There's still no clue on how they and what they will do with their debtors, when they're going to pay back something. They need to pay 150 million again next week. We had Fantasia, which is also a
That's
construction
really
company,
important to mention, yeah.
And they also failed to pay 206 million. So you cannot say that there's nothing going on and that it will be solved easily, because it's massive amounts of money that need to be paid off. And obviously, it's already the second company, large company, that is not paying off. Staying in China, positive news from there. Alibaba up 8.3%, and also Tencent yesterday about 8% up, mainly because the US-China relationships, the nervousness about that faded away a little bit. And also the stocks, obviously, how much when they were, you mentioned it last week, I think, or something, that the stocks was down already about 40-50%.
Alibaba.
Alibaba,
yeah, 50%.
So fundamentally, obviously,
this year, eh?
Fundamentally, it is also starting to become, if you dare to say that, and we're obviously not recommending stocks, but it's starting to become fundamentally interesting, I think.
Yeah, but what you say about the other company, and there's not a lot of news about Evergrande,
No.
so people, they forget it.
Well, there is one thing. This evening, Chinese time, there is a massive conference call with all the foreign
investors.
Yeah, all the foreign bond investors. So the larger, like Amundi and Goldman
I'm
Sachs. And
happy that I'm not one of them.
No. So you're not in the call. I won't see you in the call then. Okay, gas,
yeah,
natural
gas,
gas.
That's hot. But before that, I want to talk about what's next, because we always have the item what's next and what's coming on, and then I'm going to talk about James Bond.
Oh,
so now
nice.
You have the reason to stay, because that is an interesting item also. Gas, 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 gas. Okay, first of all, gas is of course, is also an energy like oil, but it's quite different, because if you travel, you can put it in a pipeline. But if you want to travel it overseas, then you have to do something with it. You must make a liquid out of it. So that's a different, an extra process.
Tell us about that process.
If you compare it with oil. No, I'm not going to tell you about it. Not at all. And by nature, the companies that are doing well in that sector are the ones that operate in the infrastructure, because they have a cash flow that's quite stable. But this, now what you said, it's all about gas. And I wanted to approach it from the economic perspective, what is going on, but I also want to talk a little bit, how is it for us as consumers?
Yeah.
How do we face it with the gas price? Do we see it directly
in
our invoices? I think there are some quite straightforward, quite clear reasons why the price went up. And of course, with everything, it's supply and demand.
Obviously.
And last winter, there was a lot of demand for gas price. I think it was worldwide, and it was a cold winter. I don't know. We are in Spain. It was not that cold.
We don't suffer from that too much.
I have gas at home, eh? So I have my a gas heater. So I'm worried about my gas
consumption.
Yeah, for prices. The next winter. Yeah. Okay, but so that's the first reason. Worldwide, more consuming of gas last winter. And the main one is the gas. Okay, so they get gas out of the ground during the year, but there's not a lot of demand during the summer. So what they store it, and normally the storage should be around this time, so the beginning of October, around 82%. So it will go up in the 90%.
Yeah,
but
so
it's
yeah,
only
yeah, so the, yeah, yeah.
yeah. It's only at this moment only 50%. Only 50%. That's because mainly they misjudged it and they thought, okay, the demand won't be that big. But also because the price was already high, so they decided, okay, they made a bet not to take that much out of the ground. But that's the main reason.
But that gas is still in the ground now.
Yeah, yeah.
So they can basically increase production, you would say.
Yeah, but you have only 1 month. Because the people are going to consume
it
in November, so you can't make it.
It goes too far to talk about if that's possible or not, but I understand what you're saying.
Probably not. And the third reason, I didn't realize that, is that gas is also used for electricity, and there was not a lot, that's what I knew, but there was not a lot of wind this year, and wind energy is also a big supplier for electricity, so they took extra gas for the electricity production. And the fourth one is also an important one, so supply and demand. The economies worldwide, you know, they
are booming.
Are booming, and not a lot of people expected that. So a lot of companies ask for more gas, especially from Asia. And if you look at Europe, only a part of it is coming from Russia, but Russia is an important player in this field because you said it this week when Putin says something. You have a problem in Europe, we're going to help you.
It's such a nice man.
So that's the four main reasons, but I think the biggest reason is that they don't have enough gas, only 50%. And the fifth one, because gas is related to the oil price. Oil price is high. The US mainly asked the OPEC, please produce more, we need more. So and they said, no, until now we're not going to do that. So so they're not supplying.
I heard on the radio that motorists, people driving cars in the US, they're paying 7 times more than normal, the highest prices in 10 years time.
Yeah, if you look at a gallon in the average price is now $3.22 in the US. In California is, for example, $4 per gallon. And in Mono County, I don't know exactly what it is, it's $5. So it's also big differences in the US itself.
Absolutely.
So I think that's are the main reasons why the price is going up. And if you look at your bill at home, it depends per country in Europe, but 40% is based off the bill from the gas price itself. And then you have the price of the network, the infrastructure, that's around 20%, so that's quite fixed because that doesn't change. And then 40% is tax. And of course, tax is related on the other ones, but if you look at one euro, that's about the difference. So that's the good thing for us, for consumers, that if the gas price doubles, that you don't see it directly in your bill. No. That's really positive. Because we don't want to pay. And it also depends where you live in Europe, of course, but mainly you have a contract for a certain year.
Yeah.
In the Netherlands, for example, you have a contract for 1, 3, or 5 years. So if you took a new contract in June this year for 5 years, nothing to worry about because they can't increase the prices, only the prices for the network, but that doesn't change a lot. So and normally the prices are reviewed, the contract, they end at 1st of July or the 1st of January. So that's also, if you have a dynamic contract, then you are more
flexible.
More in trouble, because then directly the prices are in your bill.
Just made a comment that didn't make sense. Sorry for that.
Okay. If you look at companies, for Shell is, for example, they're famous because of their oil production, but they're also really a big gas player. And But of course, I said what kind of stocks are interesting that are normally the infrastructure stocks. But if you look, want to look at the basket, there are ETNs.
Yeah.
They invest in gas, and you can also buy ETNs from WisdomTree, for example.
Yeah,
they are leveraged 2 or 3 times, and also short.
Yeah.
But be aware, because it's a difficult market, but then you are, I think, I hope, maybe a little bit less risk than buying an individual stock.
Yeah, absolutely.
So that was my
speech about gas.
Speech about gas. Yeah.
I liked it. Good.
Yeah. But now, what's next?
Well,
we start and I close down with 007.
Oh, with 007. Now, well, of course, next week, as for you as an investor, important, very important, the FOMC meetings, the minutes, they're coming out next week. We got the Chinese PPI on Thursday, and of course, the earnings season kicks off fully next week with mainly U.S. banks presenting their figures. So, a lot of things to happen again next week, I think.
I'm going to James Bond tomorrow.
Oh,
finally!
Finally, yes.
I think
people that watch us every week, they know now that you like James Bond a lot.
Yeah, I don't go to the movies that much, but I always go to James Bond. And I think this movie was postponed for 1.5 years.
Yeah.
So I have tomorrow a day out. But if you look at James Bond,
well, tell us all about it next week.
Yeah, No. I want to approach it from an investment perspective. And I asked you before, and then you looked at my paper, so you know the answer. So I'm not going to ask you anymore. But the budget for this movie, what's the name of this movie, Martin?
Dr. No.
This movie. No Time to Die.
No Time to Die. Yeah. It's almost like sort of the same, never lies, dies. Why?
Yeah, you have a lot of, I can say that. Okay, so around between 250 and $300 million is the budget. And the previous one was from 2015, and that name was Spectre.
Spectre.
And it's interesting to see that the budget was the same.
Oh, so the price hasn't gone up.
Within James Bond movies, no inflation.
But there's one thing that the actors in this one are not so famous, I think, no?
I don't know. I don't know.
But I saw
but it's the same James Bond.
Yeah, James is the same. But I think the other ones, the bad guy this time, is not as famous as...
Don't say anything, I want to see it tomorrow.
I mean, Javier Bardem is more famous than the one that is the bad guy now.
Next week I will tell you everything about it. So, the budget was also last time around $250 million. And what they raised, they through the... you have a name for the films, the revenues. Okay, it was $720 million. So it was quite, from an investment perspective, it's quite interesting. If you look at the first James Bond film from 1962, Dr. No, it had a budget of $1 million. Okay, and don't talk about inflation.
They still put it on TV nowadays.
But it raised $60 million.
Every day, still raising, no?
Yeah. And the costs are fixed. Look at James Bond from an investing perspective, we can't invest in it. It's a great investment because if this is will go over the $700 million, then you triple your money.
I think people are really looking forward also to these sorts of things.
Yeah.
And you are the clearest example of somebody that's looking to go out and go and watch this movie. Yeah?
Definitely. I will tell you everything about it next week. Thank you for watching. Give us a thumb
next
and
week.
Hope to see you next week.
Bye.